I keep seeing these videos in my recommended where people make a Discord bot, but the problem with all of them is that their bots are just so boring. So I'm here to fix that. This is my brand new Discord bot, Snailbot Plus. Before I talk about how I made it, let's go back a bit. Back in 2020, I made a Discord bot called Snailbot. It only did a few things. You could use the snail command and it would give you an image of a snail. It had some general boring admin stuff like a purge command and a mute command. And it had the OOC or out of context command, which would send a random screenshot of a super out of context Discord message. I thought I could just reuse some of what I learned from that, but I was dead wrong. And I'll get to why later. Now, sadly, I shut off Snailbot a while ago because the code was getting outdated and I wanted to use my Raspberry Pi I was hosting it on for completely legal emulators. But I haven't used it in months, so I might as well get something running on it. First, I had to set up the bot, and remember how I said that I wouldn't be able to reuse any of my background knowledge? Well, the reason for that is because I want to use slash commands, which are a new Discord feature that has a completely different system I have to learn from scratch. But anyway, obviously the first thing I did once I had it finally set up was to port over the out of context command so that you could get a random image from a selection of very questionable messages. It's kind of the main feature that people use the original bot for, so I kinda had to. And to go with those, I also re-added the snail command that gives you a random image of a snail and the escargot command, which I upgraded a bit so it now mutes you from chatting when you use it, because I thought that'd be kinda funny. The next feature I added is an idea I've had for a bit. The bot sends your usual welcome and exit messages, and it chooses a random message to go with it, but the different part is that when someone joins, it also assigns them a random color rule to make the member list look nice. Right now it's just a visual thing, but I might use them for something in the future, who knows. For some reason, people really like to use the 8-ball feature of the original Snailbot for important decision making, so I re-added that, but I made it a bit better with some really overly sarcastic responses. I'm gonna ask it the question that I'm sure we've all got on our minds. That wasn't supposed to happen. Well, I also made a rate command that rates stuff from 0 to 100. Alright, let's try this again. Okay, what the heck is going on here? Okay, no, you know what? This is fine. I'm just gonna calm down. This is the media-only channel. In this channel, you can send everything, except for text, because I thought that would be kinda cool. I think it's going pretty well so far. It's been put to pretty good use. I also made some reaction rules, a suggestion button.
Okay, did I ask?
Shoot, get out of here. I mean, if you're gonna be like that, I guess I can get to the big thing. I wanted an economy system, but just typing slash work and getting points isn't very fun at all. Honestly, it's like really boring. So I designed a system where whenever you send a message, there's a small chance of it having a snail reaction. Then, whoever taps the reaction first gets some points so people can fight over getting snails in conversations. I also didn't want snails to just be another completely useless server currency, so I made it so you can use them to do fun things like time someone out for a few seconds, change the bot nickname, send a message in the announcements channel, or imitate another member. You can also gamble your points away. Now I know what you're thinking, you only need to be over 13 to use Discord, should you really be teaching kids to gamble at such a young age? But if there's anything I've learned from arcades, it's that it's perfectly fine to teach kids to gamble as long as they don't realize that's what they're doing, which is why I'm gonna call it randomize instead. If you're thinking any of this sounds a little too irresponsible, then don't worry, I do have precautions in place, like having the bot log everything in a channel. If that gives you some peace of mind, maybe you should join the server. It's linked in the description, you know where. And if you've got any ideas for the bot or the server in general, submit them with the fancy suggestion button in the rules channel. Somehow I got to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8,000 subscribers since my last video, so desk reveal. I hope you enjoyed seeing my desk. Like, subscribe, and give me money now if you want. The button. Bye.